جايين من كل مكان للصويرة زينة البلدان زورون رجع فرحان كفى بالو للهلولة حط السلاح حطو محيلة ضربو شوفارة الليلة
بيشوت معايا بقى بوتاي With the permission of Hashem, I would like to wish you, to all of you, good week. And Be'ezat Hashem, soon it's Hanukkah, and I would like to wish you a good Hanukkah. There is the parasha of this week, is the parasha of Yosef. When Yosef was exiled from his house, and he was sold. And in this parasha, we understand a big connection between Yosef and the miracle of Hanukkah. Because we see here that without Torah, it's impossible to remain a Jew. And we saw that Yosef HaTzadik, when he was sold to the Egyptian, he was in Egypt, but what saved him to remain a good Jew, only the Torah that he was repeated, the Torah that his father Yaakov teach him, and that's what helped him in Egypt to remain a good Jew. And you see, on the other hand, the Jews in Israel, at the time of the Hashmonaim and the Greek, what the Jews, unfortunately, they nearly being all assimilated because he did not study Torah. And according to the Ba'a, it rushed to Me'avodah. Even the Kohanim, the way they worked in the Beit HaMikdash, it was not with all their heart. They just worked slowly. That means when you have to serve Hashem, you must serve Hashem, you know. You have to wake up, you have to be strong, with love. Think, I mean, like when you count money, you can't wear the money, so you need the exact account. When it comes to, you pray to Hashem, you must measure your word, what you say to Hashem, how you do the mitzvot. I mean, if the mitzvot should be well done. Now we understand why this always the history of Yosef, it's always around Hanukkah. It's to tell you, and this is the reason as well, why we light the Hanukkah, every year, to remind us the light represents the Torah. Without Torah, we are in danger. Without Torah, a Jew can be in danger of assimilation. And this is the light is the Torah. And to remind you that the Jews at that time, because they did not study Torah, because they did not pray well, nearly the well, all of them were assimilated with the Greek, and that could have been the end of them. Thanks God that Hashem sent the Hashmonaim in the fight the Greek, and they threw them out from Eretz Israel, and they re-established the Torah in Eretz Israel. That, and always, this history, it always came in the parasha of Yosef, when Yosef was sold, and he was only 17. But keep Yosef a good Jew, tzaddik, only because of the Torah. Without the Torah, could have been lost. The more Torah that his father gave him, and the more Yosef was strong. And this is the parasha of Vayeishev, because Yosef, Yaakov Abinu, he wanted to study Torah with tranquility, with no problem. So Hashem said, okay, Baruch Hashem, thank you. Okay, you have no problem, but the Torah should be studied with a lot of effort. If there is no effort, it's like if you run, the more you run, the more quick you get to the place where you want to go. So this is when you study Torah, you have to study Torah by, you know, like if you run. So the more, the quickest you run, so you reach the place where you want to go. So if you want to reach what Hashem wants from you, it must be, it has to be, you know, with zrizut, not quick, you know, with zrizut, you know, to do it quick, and to do it nice, and to do it, you know, with life, with emotion. I mean, if you walk just slowly, so you fall asleep. Look at a lot of people, when they start to pray slowly, they fall asleep. But when they move, you don't sleep. And this is when you do, when you do, you have to move. You have to, like we're walking, move your body, keep going. Otherwise you fall asleep. And this is, my friend, the parasha of this week. Yaakov Avinu Alav Hashalom, he said to himself, well, Esav is not here anymore. He's far away from here. I have no problem. If we think he's quiet, if we think he's nice, so I can sit, not Torah, with no problem, you know. And Hashem said, no, I'm not happy with you. Because if you go that way, well, it could be dangerous, spiritually dangerous for you, for your children. No, the Torah should be learning, studying, with effort, with emotion, with sacrifice, I mean, with love. Yeah. Look, when somebody wants to sleep, how people sleep? They get in bed and they put their head on the pillow, slowly, they fall asleep. But usually people don't sleep when they walk. So the study of the Torah is the same. You have to study the Torah with effort. Otherwise, if you study the Torah with tranquility, you feel asleep. And then the Torah will be with no emotion, with no love. And that's what happened during the Greek. The Greek, because the Jews, they did not study the Torah with effort, well, look what happened to them. That's why we compare the Torah as the light of the candle. You know, the light of the candle always moves. When you light a candle, always the candle move. Always it moves. So a man who studies Torah should always keep going, keep moving. Musiv olech. And that's why when we light the candles of Hanukkah, we start by one. After we light two, three. I mean, you have to go further and further and further and further till you reach the level that you need. But this is very, very important. My friend, now we understand why the connection with Yosef and Hanukkah and the parasha of Vayeishev. My friend, there is something that I want to tell you. When Moshe Rabbeinu, it's something very, very important. When Moshe Rabbeinu, he wanted to make the Jews cross the sea, Hashem told him, Moshe, you just show your hand to the sea, and the sea will divide in two parts, and then tell the Jews to cross. So that's what Moshe Rabbeinu did. He showed his hand to the sea, and the sea will not split in two sides. So Moshe Rabbeinu said to the sea, well, Hashem told me to tell you that you have to split so the Jews can cross, and the sea will not listen. Then Hashem appeared to the sea, and the sea saw Hashem, so quickly the sea, you know, split, you know, in two pieces, and divided, and the Jews, they cross the sea. So the question is a big question. There is a Gemara who said about Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair. When Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he was walking, he wanted to cross a river, and he did not have a boat to cross the river. So what Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair did, he talked to the river, and he said to the river, "I want to cross. I want you to divide yourself, so I can cross." So the river will not answer. The river just not answer. So Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he said, "Well, river, if you don't split, I will dry you. There will be no water anymore here." So when the river, she heard this, the river quickly she split. The Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he crossed the river. So the Or HaChaim HaKadosh, he asked a big question. He said, "I do not understand. Moshe Rabbeinu, he was the tzaddik of the generations. He was the master of the Torah. How it's possible that the boss, Moshe Rabbeinu, he took to the sea to split in the name of Hashem, and the sea will not listen to him? And how it's possible that the river, she listened to Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, that he was a few thousand years later? What? The student is more important than the master? Moshe Rabbeinu is the big tzaddik. He's the one who did a lot of miracles. How it's possible that the sea will not listen to the Moshe Rabbeinu, and the river, she listened to Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair? How it's possible?" And the Or HaChaim HaKadosh, he gave a beautiful answer. He said, "Because at the time of Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, when he talked to the sea, to the river, to split, he had the zichud of the Torah. With the zichud of the Torah, he could do anything. Look, all the tzaddikim, all the miracles that tzaddikim does. How did he do all those kind of miracles? Only because they studied the Torah. Without Torah, they cannot do nothing." So this is the lesson. At the time of Moshe Rabbeinu, okay, it's Hashem who told Moshe Rabbeinu to talk to the sea. But the sea will not listen to Moshe Rabbeinu, because Moshe Rabbeinu, he needed the koach of the Torah. He did not receive yet the Torah. And because he did not receive yet the Torah, so the sea will not listen to Moshe Rabbeinu. Even as Hashem told Moshe, talk to the sea, it will not listen to Moshe, because the sea can only listen to Hashem, not to Moshe. Now you understand. I think this is the lesson. That's why Hashem appeared to the sea. And Hashem said to the sea, "Do as Moshe Rabbeinu told you, because they're going to go now to receive the Torah. Because they're going to go to receive the Torah, you listen to him. Otherwise, the sea will not listen to Moshe Rabbeinu." From here you see, only through the Torah can help you. Now you see Yosef HaTzadik. What helped Yosef HaTzadik to remain a good Jew in Egypt? Only because always the name of Hashem was in his mouth, and always he was studying the Torah. He did not forget when, 22 years later, when Yosef HaTzadik, he divided himself to his brothers, and he told them, "I am Yosef, your brothers." He told them, "Tell Papa that I did not forget the Torah. Since I left him 22 years ago, I carry on studying the Torah. Even my two sons, Ephraim and Menashe, test them, you will see that they know the Torah. I teach them the Torah every day." The Torah protects. The study of the Torah protects. It's very important. It's very, very important. One day, Now you understand why the Jews at the time of Moshe Rabbeinu, when they were all near the sea, just imagine, Moshe Rabbeinu was standing, he talked to the sea, hey, sea, splay yourself, we have to cross. The sea, no reaction. Just imagine. The Jews were shocked. For the first time, they see something incredible. Moshe Rabbeinu did a lot of miracles in Egypt. Above nature. He changed the water to the blood. You know, the ten makot, the ten plagues that Moshe Rabbeinu, he did in the name of Hashem in Egypt. I mean, the nature changed. And never we saw that the nature will say to Moshe Rabbeinu, we don't listen to you. Because you have no Torah. We only listen to Hashem. You know why? Because all the miracles that Moshe Rabbeinu did in Egypt, he did not do them in front of the Jews. He did them in front of Pharaoh. For Pharaoh, we don't care. But. And the sea, when Moshe Rabbeinu was talking to the sea, split yourself. That was in front of all the Jews. And the whole Jews were there. All the Jews were there. That was very, very important. That the Jews see and listen that without Torah, there is no miracles. You can do only miracles. You can change the world. You can change nature only if you have the koach of the Torah. Yes. In Egypt, excuse me, listen to this. In Egypt, even that Moshe Rabbeinu changed the nature listened to Moshe. Because all what Moshe Rabbeinu did in Egypt, that was to punish Pharaoh. But here, the miracle that happened in the sea, that was for the Jews. Because that was for the benefit of the Jews to cross. And here, that kind of miracle for the Jews to cross, you need Torah. The Jews need the zechut of the Torah. They have no Torah yet. And Moshe cannot split the sea. He did not receive the Torah yet. So that way Hashem, he had to appear to the sea and tell the sea, hey, you listen to Moshe. Because they are going to cross the sea to receive the Torah. My friend, now you understand. Now we understand how much it's so important. Yes. How much it's so important, the study of the Torah. The study of the Torah helps you. The study of the Torah helps you to connect you, not only with Hashem, but to remain use a strong Jew with Hashem. Yes. Look, yeah, Avraham Avinu, Hamash, he was the first one who teach Emunah to people to believe in Hashem. Hamash, he was nice to Lot, his nephew, even that he was not good. Hamash, Avraham Avinu was a big tzaddik when he heard that Hashem would destroy Sodom. He prayed for them. Hashem, give them a chance. Look, Avraham Avinu. When he heard that Lot was kidnapped, he risked his life to save him. Look when Hashem told him to do the Brit Milah, to do the circumcision. He asked his friends, can I do it? The question is, why he asked his friend? Of course, if he has to do it, he has to do it. If Hashem told him to do it, he has to do it. Why to ask? No. He didn't want to ask their advice to do it or not to do it. Of course he would do it. Just he wanted to let them know that, look what I'm going to do, so that he can do marketing for him. that he can tell to everybody, look, this old man, what he is willing to do. And the parasha of the Akedah, and this is very important, I would like you to learn to this. When he did the Akedah, when he sacrificed his son, then the Malach came, and he said to Abraham, Abraham, stop. Now I know. Now I know that you fear Hashem. What does that mean? Now I know that you fear Hashem. What do you mean that? Ki yire Elokim ata. Of course he fear Hashem. Why do we have a moment to think that he don't fear Hashem? Of course he fear Hashem. But the answer is, ki yire Elokim ata. The answer is, ki is the Rashitivot Lev, Gematria Lev. Ki yire Elokim ata. Rashitivot Gematria Lev. If you do a calculation, ki yire Elokim ata, if you take the first letters, is the calcul of Lev, the heart. That means that usually we don't know people if they fear Hashem or not. Yes, we can see people, they fear Hashem, but isn't their heart fear Hashem as well? That we don't know. Only Hashem knows. A lot of people, you see them doing religion from the outside, but do they feel it inside? That we don't know. When you do a mitzvah, not only you have to do it with your heart, from your outside, but with your heart as well. Most of people, they do mitzvot, but do they feel it in their heart? Fearing Hashem is in the heart. But a lot of times we may see people, we think they fear Hashem, but no one knows. Fearing Hashem is from the inside, not from the outside. When you see a lion, the fear of the lion, it's from the inside, it's inside, not from the outside, inside as well. That's what Hashem said to Abraham. Now I know that you fear Hashem, you have your Hashem not only from the outside, but inside as well. Yeah, it's fabulous. It's, look, I would just tell you another thing about Abraham Avinu. Something incredible about Abraham. After the circumcision, something happened. First thing he did, he was sitting outside. Instead of going to bed and sleep, because after this operation that he did, he was 100 years old. No, in the big heat, the hot weather, it was outside, waiting for maybe somebody came, passed, to invite him to eat. That's what the Torah starts, the parasha of Vayera, Vayera, Hashem, he appeared to Abraham. And at that moment that Hashem appeared to Abraham, Abraham was sitting outside the tent. He was waiting for guests to pass. I mean, why do that? And the Torah starts with this. Instead of the Torah, we start with something else. There's a lot of stories that the Torah starts with this because it's so important to be maker of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You need chesed to be brought to Hashem, to be connected really to Hashem. Now, Abraham Avinu, after the Brit Milah, he did the Brit, he did the alliance with Hashem. Now he's connected to Hashem. Now he's Mekabah to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So now he must be like Hashem. Hashem is Hesed. All what Hashem does all the time, doing good things. So now Abraham Avinu said to Hashem, now that I did the Brit, now that I did an alliance with you, so now I have to copy you. Now I have to be like a photocopy, I have to be like you. The same way that you always do Hesed, so even now that I just did an operation, now that I should be in bed, no. Now I want to do Hesed. I want guests, I want to give something, I want to welcome people, I want to help people. This is the way to look like Hashem. Hesed. This is, my friend, it's a beautiful way. There is three levels. And the three levels to approach Hashem. First, Hesed. Be a good man. Then Avodah. Pray to Hashem. Then Torah. Abraham, Isaac, Yaakov. I mean, don't start from Torah, then Avodah, then Chesed. No. Start with Chesed, Avodah, then Torah. Abraham, Isaac, Yaakov. Abraham was the symbol of Chesed. Then now you go to the next level. Chesed, Emunah. Next level is Tfilah. To connect yourself to Hashem. Now that you do Chesed, that you are connected to Hashem, now that you look like Hashem, now, and you believe on Him, now you have to connect yourself at the highest level, Tefillah. When you reach Chesed, Emuna, and Tefillah, now we have to study Torah. Yes, my friend. My friend, and I would like to finish with this. You know, on Sukkot, we pray with the lulav, the etrog, the arava, and the hadas that represent unity, that represent the eyes, the mouth, the body, the heart. Etrog, it represents the heart. You should have the heart in your hand. You look at it. You take the etrog on the left hand side because your heart is in the left. You see the etrog, how beautiful it is. So your heart should be beautiful. All your body, Sevig Hashem, all your body. Serve Hashem is not easy. And this is that's what Hashem said to Abraham Avinu. Ki yirei Elokim ata. You're beautiful from the inside and outside. You fear Hashem. A lot of people, they show you, they think, they fear Hashem. But only Hashem knows the truth. My friend, I would like just to finish with one thing. Hizkiah Melech, the King Hizkiah, he was a man of Torah. He had no weapon, he had no army, nothing. All his life, his kingdom was full of Torah. No weapon, nothing. And then, the king Sanherib, he was a big king. He came to fight him with family and soldiers. And Hizkiah, he had no weapon, no soldiers, nothing. There were only yeshivot. Jews at that time, they were only studying Torah. So what happened? Hizkiah, he went to Beit HaMikdash. He started to pray to Hashem. Hashem, I have no weapon. I have no soldiers. I have nobody. Please Hashem, help me. You said that if we study Torah, with the merit of the Torah, we will win the war. Now, I don't know. I have no weapon to start a war against this man who came with 4 million soldiers. And now if I surround myself, it will be no good for you, Hashem. People will say, this is risky, I will listen to what the Torah said, and this is the reward that Hashem gave him. No, Hashem, don't do that to me. Hashem, he said to the prophet Ishaya, God tell him, don't worry. Tonight, Sanherib with all his army, all of them, they will die. Only the king and his children, they will remain alive to see the miracle. So don't worry. Go to bed, go to sleep, don't worry. And there was a big miracle. All of them, all the soldiers, that night they died. Big miracle. So Hashem, he wanted to make Chizkiyah Mashiach. Because the big miracle that was very well known all over the world. But the angels, they said to Hashem, no, you cannot make him Mashiach because he did not say the Shira, he did not sing, he did not tell you thank you with songs. When the Jews left Egypt and when they crossed the sea, they said, as Hashem Moshe Ben Israel, they sang to you Asherah. And then they said, Hashem Imloch Leon Havayet. Then they said that you, Hashem, you will be the king of the kings. And Chizkiyah didn't say that. He saw the miracle. He saw 4 million soldiers killed, die, and he became very rich. All the wealth that Sanherib had took it. And he didn't say Shira. What? So he lost the title of Mashiach. The question is, it's impossible to believe that Chizkiyah will not say thank you to Hashem. He will not give a song with happiness to Hashem. Thank you, Hashem, for all what you did. It's impossible to believe that. The answer is, Chizkiyah Melech, he was a man of Torah. He thought, the best shira that I can give to Hashem is to go to the yeshiva and sit and learn Torah. Because if Hashem saved us tonight from being killed from the hand of Sanherib, it's because of the Torah that we study. Because we have no weapon, we have no soldiers. And our weapon is the Torah. So this is the way to thank Hashem. That's what Chizkiyah thought. That was Chizkiyah. Chizkiyah for him, it was only Limud HaTorah, to study Torah. But unfortunately, he made a mistake. There is time to study, and there is time to say thank you. We cannot mix. Everything has a time. It's a timing. The time that you have to play is not the time that you have to study. There is a time, like Shlomo HaMelech said, it's time to live, time to die, time to study, time to sleep, time to work. Everything has a time. There is a timing. Now, there is a time to say thank you to Hashem. Now, this is a time to sing to Hashem. And that is very important. There is time to study the Torah. But there is time that you have to stop from studying Torah and to pray to Hashem. And to sing. This time to do Shira. You know, Hanukkah it's not a holiday to eat like we do in Pesach, Sukkot, Purim. Hanukkah it's a holiday. We can work, but when we light the candles, we're not allowed to work. But it's not a time to eat food, to make a seuda. Hanukkah is to sing, to say thank you to Hashem. Purim is to drink, to do a seuda. Because the miracle of Purim, it was because of the seuda that Esther did to Ahasuerus and Haman, and through that seuda, Haman was killed, and that's it. Hanukkah, the miracle of Hanukkah, is to say thank you to Hashem that we are not assimilated. And that song stood the Torah in song. But at the time that you light the candle, Ma'us tu yesh, we have to sing. And of course, Torah is singing in this story. My friend, you see, for all what I told you, the more you study the Torah, the more you will understand, you will have more love to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Torah, the Torah protects. And one thing I tell you, never mixed. Everything has a time. There is a timing for everything. God bless you, and wish you all the best, and happy Hanukkah. Thank you.